Hey guys, how's it going? Hope things are great with you. I'm going to talk to you something about this thing called manas, okay? Because I keep saying it again and again, and many out there are still confused what is it. So it is only fair that I should elaborate and to hopefully make you understand what it means. Now, the manas is the facilitation of our day-to-day activities. It helps us to guide us on a day-to-day basis. The manas is also to be said as the mind, okay? But how does it actually work? Now, we all know that the moon is the karaka for the mind. But how does it actually work in our day-to-day activity? So, let's talk about a concept called Atman, okay? The Atman is, okay, we all know the Atman is the soul. And that's a perpetual divine energy that keeps going from life to life, from janma to janma, okay? Now, that is what Vedic astrology all about. We study about the evolutionary process of the soul, not so much of the human factor, but the soul's involvement on us, okay? So, the Atman, I'm going to break that into four different parts, okay? Now, modern psychology talks about the human psyche is divided in your conscious mind, which means things that you do consciously, subconscious mind, the things that you do subconsciously, of course, you have the collective consciousness, the super conscious, as they call it. This is modern psychology, but in Hindu psychology, there are four components, and these four components encapsulates the Atman. Okay, first is the Manas, which is the conscious part of things that we do in the day-to-day, or rather the automatic response that we do on a day-to-day basis, like, you know, driving and eating and talking to friends and stuff like that. It doesn't require much of a thought process. The second is the ahamkara, the ego, the self-identity. Like I can take myself, you know, I'm a human, I'm a male, I'm a father, astrologer, chess grandmaster, whatever. You know, that is the self-identity, ahamkara. Now, this ahamkara can sort of go out of bounds sometimes. We can turn into false pride and things. But just to be within this context of this video, just understand that ahamkara is the identity, the one that tells who we are. Okay, so that's the second component of the Atman. The third is the chitta. Chitta is the subconscious part of the mind. That's the one that, you know, that happens behind the scenes. That is the more powerful ones. So chit is used for not just psyche, but it is used for more more advanced processes of thinking. Kriya and Jnana Yoga talks about this chit. It's a very difficult topic to cover, but just put it this way, it's just it's a repository of our subconscious activities, okay? So you have the manas, you have the chitta, you have the ahankara, and you have the buddhi. Buddhi is the intellect, the decision-making component. You know, should I be doing that? Is this a good decision? Any sort of thought process which requires decision-making, discretions, analytical thinking, logical approach, all this is called the buddhi. Okay, that is the sort of the storehouse for making more, you know, meaningful decisions in life, okay, in your day-to-day activity. So these four components, the moon, manas, the buddhi is mercury, and then ahankara, the ego, and then you have the chitta, which is the subconscious mind. There are all these four components encapsulated, put together, packaged in, it's called the Atma. All right, so manas, now you know manas is one part of the Atma which controls our automatic responses in our day-to-day activities. Mainly it controls the sensory or the indriyas. Okay, hope this helped, guys. And if you have any questions, please leave a comment and do subscribe if you like my videos. Thank you. Namaste.